being able to collect information about your network devices, servers, workstation all around your company is not an easy task. It's even harder when you have isolated networks, complex networks, and you can't install a GLPI agent in every single computer of your network. Or if you need an SNMP inventory, for example, you can use the GLPI agent installed in just one device and you can get information about your whole network. And I'm going to show you how. Hi, my name is Artur Schiffer and welcome back to the TechLib YouTube channel. The GLPI agent, since its 1.6 version, has a new tool called GLPI Agent Toolbox, where you can configure some tasks, including the network discovery and inventory, where you can discover SNMP devices, and you can even configure a task to have agentless discovery, which means you can have SSH, SNMP, WinRM, and ESX inventory using just one agent in your network. For sure, you need this agent to have access to this network and to collect data from these servers. And to make sure it happens correctly, we are just needing these four things. At least one device with the GLPI agent 1.6 or above, which means if it's below 1.6, we don't have the agent, the toolbox agent. Also, the toolbox activated, for sure. And the list of IP ranges, which means if we have like 5, 6, 7 VLANs or complex networks that we want to scan, we need all of them, we need the ranges. And also the list of SSH, WinRM for Windows devices, and SNMP credentials. If you have ESX in your network, we can also add them to the credentials list. But in this case, in this demonstration, I don't have ESX, so I'm going to show you the SSH and SNMP credentials being stored and inventoried. To show you how this network is configured, let's take a look at it. I have an office lab, which is 172.16.10, and it's a 24-bit network. These servers in gray, these devices in gray, are on my local network, and these orange network here, which is 172.16.19, and it's a 16-bit network, it's a Docker network. And this GLPI agent is installed on this Aramis, which is the 172.16.10.252. And this server has access to these Docker containers, but none of this has access to these containers. Also, this Lightbeam 5G, which is an older access point, has its SNMP protocol enabled. Let's go to the configuration of the GLPI Agent Toolbox. To configure the GLPI Agent Toolbox, we need to go to our configuration and set the disable to no, and I'm going to show you right now. Here, I'm navigating to the GLPI Agent configuration files. As you can see here, I have the plugins configuration, and I'm going to configure the toolbox plugin. Remember, this toolbox plugin is recommended to be used in safe networks, so you don't enable it in unsafe networks, because you have access to password, you have access to IP ranges if you let it configured, and you can also improve the security of it, enabling the SSL server and also the authentication, which is a simple authentication. And you can find more stuff in here in the HTTP interface, where we have the basic authentication server plugin, the SSL server plugin, and you can make it more secure. And also you can add the IP addresses that can access this GLPI agent toolbox in the agent configuration. Now we are going to restart the GLPI agent and try to access this via our browser. The port is 62354, which is the default network, default port of our agent. And we are going to add a toolbox at the end of this IP address. As you can see here, we have just two menu, we can't configure the inventory task without the IP ranges and also the credentials and the scheduling. Let's activate four menu bars, which are the credentials one, the IP ranges one, and the scheduling one. We don't need the results because we are not running the task on an agent folder. We are sending the information to our server. Let's just hit update and let's come back to the configuration. So here we have the IP ranges. So remember, I have some ranges here. So I have the Docker range, I have the local range, and to make it quickly, I will create two ranges just for the servers and for the other devices, even though they are in the same IP range. So let's come back here and let's put just servers, like local servers. And then we are going to hit 172.16.10.12, for example, 172.16.10.25. And, oh, sorry, it's the servers, so 250 and 254. Servers, add IP range, and we're going to add also a new IP ranges for Docker network, which is 172.19.0.1 to 172.19.0.5, for example. Docker devices. And we are going to also add the devices local network 172.16.10.1, 172.16.10.25, for example. So local devices. Remember, the local devices are at the same IP range as the servers, but to make it quickly, I will separate the IP ranges so it's faster. Now I'm going to add the credentials. So for example, here I have the credential. Remember, you can see this because it's a lab. So SSH, the libssh2, the username is root. I type the password. Yeah, I know. I will add an SNMP credential, v1, 161, and I will also add a new community, public, v2. This is just a name, and here is the community user, port 1161, create a credential. I don't have any v3, so I'm not adding it here. And let's see if we have anything else. If we had any WinRAM, remember, you have to activate the WinRAM on your device and have admin rights to this user. So let's imagine I'd have an admin username and a password. So it's using the 85, okay, so WinRAM. It's just an example. I don't have any WinRAM device here. So right now we have an SNMP password credential, and we have two SNMP credentials, one root. Let's add one more. Root. Okay. Create credential. All of these credentials are stored in my password manager. So I know that every server has its credential created. A root password to, and you don't need to use a root one, but you have to have some admin credentials so the inventory is complete. Let's come back to scheduling. This scheduling of a task is split in two types. We have the delay and the time slot. The delay is when you want it to happen like every 5 hours, every 1 hour, every 12 hours, every 5 days. So it will run recurrently. So let's configure, for example, every 5 hours. Even though I'm just using it once, I'm creating it to run every 5 hours. And I could also create a time slot, which means that it will run every day or every Wednesday or every Thursday at a given time. Good. I'm not creating a time slot because I'm just showing you how it's done. Now I can create an inventory task. Let's create an inventory task. So every 5 hours, remote inventory task. This is a network scan, so it means it will scan the networks that are inserted in the IP ranges. And the target right now is going to be server, because I want it to be sent to my server, which is on the cloud. I want it to run every 5 hours. I will not add any tag, and I will associate these IP ranges. The threads are the number of connections that will be sent at the same time. And the connection timeout is the time that the agent will wait until it's going to try another device. As we are using the SSH, it's good to have at least 10 seconds timeout, because we need to wait for the response of the server. And remember, if you put too much of a timeout and too much threads, you're going to wait more to this task to be done. Since my network is very small and simple, I'm adding 5 threads and a connection timeout of 10 seconds. But there's one thing missing. We created the credentials, we created the IP ranges, but we didn't connect the passwords, the credentials, to the IP ranges that I want to make sure it works. So for example, if I have on my device's local network just devices with WinRAM, I would just add the WinRAM credentials to this network. If I had just root, I would just insert the root. So in this case, I am running on my device's local network. So I will just add my public SNMP, the public V2 SNMP, and my WinRAM. Let's imagine I would have a Windows here. And I'm not adding the roots because I don't have any device with this password here. I'm hitting update. Let's come back to IP ranges and Docker network. On my Docker network, I would just add the root and the root local. And on my IP range local servers, I will just add the roots because they are servers. And I'm hitting update. Remember to do this on your network. And let's come back to inventory tasks. Let's enable the task. So right now it will be run at 9:25. But I can force the run. But before we do that, let's activate the debug mode to 2 so we can see every step that the agent does. Right now I'm accessing the agent configuration. And I'm looking for debug mode, which is here. And I'm changing it to 2. If you go to our documentation, you will see that the debug mode, look here, we have messages exchanged with the server and activate these traces from NetSSLE if used. So it's a more complete verbose mode of debugging. Let's restart the agent since we changed some configuration, and let's come back to the inventory task and run it. Two new icons are going to appear here, which are the logs that we can follow up. So here we can see created inventories, scanned IP addresses, devices with SNMP support, IPs without SNMP response, and IPs without ping. Let's open here and we can see every step that it's running. So it's trying every IP address and trying to create remote inventory. Let's open our server. Here we have our server. Let's see how many computers we have here. We have just Aramis, since we have made an inventory before. And let's wait until it appears more devices here. See, we have here 5 scanned IPs without a ping response, because I don't have devices on those IPs. See, here we have one. This is 1017. It's probably my access point. Let's take a look. Network devices. 929, as you can see here, it's 929. Let's come back to computers. So right now it's scanning the server networks, as you can see here, from 250 254. Remember, we have created that, and it will start to inventory probably my servers if it finds any credentials. Right now it found some. See, my red hat, it's making the inventory. After the inventory is done, it will be sent to my server. And to make it faster, I will speed up this video and show you the results after it's done. For this number of IP addresses, we had like 200 seconds to run it, which is less than 5 minutes to make the inventory. Here you can see my server, and probably I didn't turn on my dockers. Yeah, I didn't turn on my dockers. So in this scenario, I had to recreate the stack of my containers. So let's make sure we change the IP range here. Let's come back to the IP ranges, and then Docker network was set to 19. As you can see here, I have the 18 here, 18.0. So let's change it to 18 and 18 again, update, and I will create just one inventory task just to make it quicker, even quicker. So we are inventorying just the Docker network. Let's create a new inventory task. Docker network. Again, network scan, delay every 5 hours. And I'm just setting the Docker network, 5 threads. I'm putting like 1 thread because it's just 3 containers, and activating it and running the task. Let's see what is happening. It found some. Look here, we have the computers, and it's appearing some. Here is one with the debian. So here we have one. Here we have two. We have the Debian, the Ubuntu, and probably the Alma Linux is coming. And okay, Aramis. And here is the Alma Linux. So now we have 3 Dockers and 2 hosts. And on our network devices, we have the Lightbeam M5 and the gateway that I inserted manually because I don't have SNMP access to this gateway. So I'm just creating it. In computers, I have all my stuff, all my containers, all my servers, just with one agent. So if you liked this video, hit subscribe, like this video, and share it with a friend or a colleague so you can have all your network information collected just using one GLPI agent. And we have other videos about the GLPI agent and the GLPI inventory, and I will let them on the description or on the show notes. So you can also answer some of your questions between differences and how to configure the GLPI agent.